We have been talking about the concept of your springs and their combination. Spring force is always proportional to displacement, but in the opposite direction. Removing the proportionality constant, we get some constant known as Fk. K is known as what? Spring constant. K is known as what for me? Spring constant. K is your spring constant. Okay, so this law is known as X law. For any given spring beta, K into L will always be for me what? Constant. K into L will be what for me? Constant. Clear? Sorry. Say for example, if I say that we got some spring beta of spring constant K. Let's say for example, a spring of force constant K. And say, for example, its natural length is, say, for example, some 6L, okay? And it is broken into three parts. Broken into your three parts of ratio, say, for example, 1:2, 2:3. My question is, find the spring constant of each. Find spring constant of each. Can anyone beta? We got a spring of spring force constant. How much for me? How much? A spring of force constant K, and natural length is 6L, and is broken into three parts. Of the three parts of length ratio, I can say here. This one will be your length ratio. Length ratio 1:2:3. Find the spring constant of each. You know that K into L will be constant, beta. If K into L is constant, total length is how much for me? 6L. So I can write here 6 times of your L. That is nothing but of your spring constant will be equal to your K1 L1. Will be equal to your K2 L2, will be equal to your K3 L3. Hello? Sir, sir. Question, sir? Achar. Achar. Is it clear, beta? K1 L1 will be equal to your K2 L2 will be equal to K3 L3. Can anyone tell me what will be the value of each and individual beta? Total spring constant is how much? Like say for example, this was your initial spring constant. Spring constant is K and length of this one is KL. That means this K into your 6L must be equal to K1 into, first ratio is how much for me beta? 1. That is nothing but 1. That is nothing means I can write as L. L and L will get cancelled. So K1 will become for me 6 times of your K. K1 is equals to 6 times. Okay. Clear for everyone? The same way. For second part, if I'm taking K into your 6L will be equal to K2 into. What is the ratio in which we have been cut it beta? Can anyone tell me? What is the ratio in which we have cut it? 1:2:3. So it is your 2L. So this L will get cancelled. So I can write here K2 is equals to your 6 into your K divided by 2. 2 1s are 2, 3 is 6. So that will be equal to your 3K. Second part. Because we have cut this one into three parts. No? So if I'm taking the spring parts of this one K1, this one as K2, and this one as K3. So now K3 will be equal to how much for me? 6L into your K effective will be equal to your K3 into. What is the next part we have cut it better? 6 into 1:2:3. That means this will become for me 3L. This L will get cancelled. 3 1s are, 3 2s are. So K3 will be equal to your 2 times of K. Clear for everyone? Is it clear? If a spring is cut into 3 parts in the ratio of 1:2:3, spring constant of each will become for me. First one is 6K, second one is a 3K, and third one is of your 2K. Clear? No doubt to anyone? Sure. चलो the springs are connected in the series combination like this. There is one spring here, there is one spring here, there is one spring here. Spring constant of this one is K1, this one is K2, this one is K3. Okay, now tell me, what will be their combination? In series combination, beta, what will be the same? Can anyone tell me? If I attach this to certain weight of block of mass M, the weight of this body is M into G in the downward direction. Okay, this force is common for the K3, K2 and K1. So extension might be in this one X1, extension in this one might be X2, and this one might be equal to X3. Clear? But force acting on each spring will be the same. So it is what combination? In series combination, in series combination, force is same for all springs. For all springs, but extensions will be different. Extensions will be different. Clear? In series combination, force is same for, because on the K3, same block is attached, K2 also same block is attached, and on K1 also same block is been attached, isn't it? So in series combination, the force is same for all the springs, but extensions will be different. Extensions will be different. Might be X1, K1 might have been extended by X1, the K2 might have been extended by X2, and K3 might have been extended by your X3 part of relation. So the spring constant force is right now for me the same. So can I write here right now for this one, K1 X1, K2 X2 must be equal to your K3 into your X3 part, isn't it? So I can write here spring force on for your first part if I'm writing right now for me. M into G will be equal to your K1 into your X1. So X1 will be equal to how much for me, beta? Mg by your K1, isn't it? The same way, Mg is equals to your K2 into your X2. So I can write here X2 will be equal to your Mg divided by your K2. The same way, Mg will be equal to your K3 into your X3. So X3 will be equal to your Mg divided by your K3. So in all of them, net extension will be equal to how much, beta? Final extension. It will be X is equals to your X1 plus X2 plus X3. Isn't it? So if I'm writing that one, so total X I can write as of your Mg divided by your K effective. Z equals to, it is your Mg divided by your K1 plus Mg divided by your K2 plus Mg divided by your K3. In all, Mg will get cancelled. So I'll be getting the formula here right now in series combination. 1 by K effective is equals to your 1 by your K1 plus of your 1 by your K2 plus of your 1 by your K3. So this is our formula. So in series combination, the effective spring constant is calculated by the formula 1 by K1 plus 1 by K2 plus 1 by K3. Is it clear for everyone? One by K effective is equals to one by K1 plus one by K2 plus one by K3. Is it clear, brother? Is that clear? So in series combination, 1 by K effective is equal to 1 by K1 plus 1 by K2. What is the thing you need to remember? In the series combination, force is same for all the springs. but extensions will be different. But extensions will be different. Is it clear? Sure. Next one. Next one. Parallel combination. In parallel combination, see what is happening. All the springs are connected side by side. So here there is one spring, here there is one spring, and here there is one spring. All the springs are connected to one single block right now here. Let's say for example, mass of your M, spring constant of this one is K1, this one is K2, this one is K3. What will be the same in this one, beta? Extension will be the same, but force will be different. Here the force will be F1, here the force will be F2, here the force will be equal to your F3. But extension will be same. Everywhere the extension will be the same. So I can write here right now, this force F1, the weight of the body, whatever I'm writing, M into G, this M into G will be equal to how much, beta? M into G is nothing but equal to your K1 into your X. Isn't it? And that means I can write here MG is nothing but what? Force. So I can say that this force F1 is equals to K1 into X. Force F2 is equals to K2 into your X. Force F3 is equals to K3 into your X. So what will be the net force for this one? F net will be equal to your F1 plus F2 plus F3. F net will be equal to K equivalent into X. That will be equal to K1 into X plus K2 into your X plus K3 into your X. Everywhere X is same, so that will get cancelled. So K effective will be equal to your K1 plus K2 plus K3. That will be the answer. Clear for everyone? Is that clear? Just a minute, go to. Need to just open some other site. No, nothing is, I was just sharing other thing basically, that's it. So let us try to do some problems based on the spring combinations, beta. Yeah, see this question, madam, everyone. Uniform rope of mass, uniform rope of length L is being pulled by a force of F. This is a something related to your variable mass condition, madam, isn't it? Because in this is a rope type of a condition in which the tension is not same everywhere. Okay, so we are talking about right now variable mass concept. Say for example, mass of your rope. I told you that in the string, the tension at each and every point will be the same. Whereas in the rope, at in each and every point, the tension will be the different, isn't it? Like say this question, uniform rope of length capital L, this is a length capital L, is being pulled by a force of capital F on a smooth surface. Find the tension in the rope at a distance of your X from the end where the force has been applied. From the point from where the force has been applied for this one. Now see, if I take an FBD of this one, this is the small part of the rod which you have been taken or rope. On this part, you are applying a force of your F. This is at a distance of your X. And this one is right now some point of your P. So there will be the tension here right now. That will be equal to your T. Okay. What will be the mass of this one, beta? Mass will be equal to, say, for example, small m. Mass of this total rope is, say, for example, capital M. So how do you write this mass, beta? Cut at mass by your original mass is equals to cut at length by your original length. Cut at mass by original length is equals to cut at length is how much for me your X. So it is your X divided by original length. That means cut at mass will be equal to how much for me beta? M by L into your X. So this is the mass which we have removed. That, like say for example, this much amount of the part mass is nothing but equal to your M. Okay, so cut at mass by original mass is equal to cut at length by original length. So M is equal to M by L into X for three for two, one dimension type of a body. So force acting on this body, I can write right now as it is moving in the front direction with an acceleration here because you are applying the force. Capital F minus of your T will be equal to mass of this body M into your acceleration here. What will be the net acceleration, beta? Net acceleration is capital F divided by capital M. Isn't it? So I can write here right now, small m will become for me capital M divided by L into your X into acceleration. Acceleration is your capital F divided by capital M. This capital M will get cancelled. This is F into your X divided by your L. And this one is F minus of your T. Clear? Is it clear? No. Now I need the value of T to be calculated. So this will be equal to your F. This minus F into your X divided by L is equals to T. So F is common, 1 minus X by L is equals to T. Isn't it? So this will be the tension. What an idea how to do for more problems related to the variable mass concept, beta. If the mass of the rope is variable or continuously been changing, for one dimension body, how do you calculate the relation? I'm writing here, see, for one dimension bodies, for 1D, cut at mass divided by original mass, divided by original mass, original mass is equals to cut at length by original length. Then, whenever you talk about one dimension body, whereas if I'm talking about two dimension body in the same way, we write here cut at mass divided by your original mass is equals to, now instead of length, you take area, cut at area by your original area. Then, the same way. For three dimension bodies, how do you take the small mass means? Cut at mass divided by original mass. Cut at mass by your original mass is equals to cut at volume divided by original volume. Clear? That means I can write here cutet mass by original mass is equals to cutet length is dx divided by length is L. That means I can write from this one dm is equals to your m by L into your dx. Whatever the part you take there, right? Isn't it? The same way here, cutet mass by your original mass is equals to cutet area by original area. That means cutet mass will be equal to your original mass by original area into cutet area. That will give me the value of your dm. Done? In the same way, cutet mass by your original mass is equals to cutet volume by original volume. That means cutet mass will be equal to your m by your v into your d. Clear? So whenever I'm talking about one dimension body like rope or anything like a strings, so for that one, cutet mass by original mass is equals to cutet length by original length. So dm by your m is equals to dx by your x. For two dimension body, area. For three dimension body, volume. Is that clear for everyone? Is that clear, beta? Let us try to do some problems based on Newton's laws of motion, beta. So the first question there, beta. So what is the first question it is telling right now? A block of mass M is acted upon by two perpendicular forces, 7 Newton and 24 Newton. Find the magnitude and direction of the acceleration of your blocks. Can anyone tell me, beta? A block of mass. Mass is given for me 5 kg. Is acted upon by two perpendicular forces. So F1 is equals to 7 Newton. F2 is equals to 24 Newton. Both of them are perpendicular. That means if this is one force like this, and this will be another force like this. If this is 24 Newton, this will be your 7 Newton. Resultant will be equal to this one. This is some resultant that is making an angle of your theta. So resultant force, how do you write here? Fr will be equal to your under root of your, this one is F1 square plus F2 square plus 2F1 F2 into cos of your theta. What is the angle between these two forces, beta? 90 degrees. So it is your cos 90. Cos 90 is 0, so this total will become for me 0. That means under root of your 7 square plus of your 24 whole square. Okay, so see how much I'm getting. Can anyone tell me what is the answer I'm really getting? How much, beta? 7 7s are 49 plus 24 into 24, 576. Isn't it? Yeah, someone is giving the answer. Root 627. Yeah, root 627 means how much it will be, beta? 25 square, 25 into 25, 5 5 is a 25, 5 here 2, 5 2 is a 10, 11, 12, 2 5 is a 10, 2 2 is a 4, 1 5. So this is 5, this is 2, 6, 6 25. That means 25 newtons. Clear? If he's asking the angle, means how do you write this angle beta? Can anyone tell me? That angle will be equal to how much? Tan theta is equals to fy divided by fx. Fy is how much for me? 24. Net force, how much we got? Tan alpha. I'll write here right now. See, here if I'm taking this one, tan theta is equals to find the magnitude and the direction of acceleration of the block. Okay, force we got. I can calculate here acceleration. Acceleration is force by mass. Force is 25. Mass is nothing but 5. 5 ones are 5 fives are. So acceleration is 5 meter per second square. So if I'm taking an acceleration angle with respect to the first vector, 7 Newton, I'll be getting that answer as of your 24 divided by 7. That means theta is equals to tan inverse of 24 divided by 7. Isn't it? That will be the answer. Clear? Now next question. Three forces. F1 is equals to 3i cap plus 2j cap minus k cap. And F2 is equals to 4i cap minus j cap minus 2k cap. And F3 is equals to 23j cap plus 3k newton are acting on a block of mass 5 kg. Calculate the acceleration of the particle. So acceleration will be equal to your force divided by your mass. Mass is given for me in the problem. Mass is given how much for me? 5 kg. I need to calculate the net force. So first calculate the net force there, beta. F is equals to your F1 plus of your F2 plus of your F3. So F1 is equals to how much for me? 3i cap plus of your 2j cap minus of your k cap. Plus. This will be 4i cap minus of j cap minus of your 2k cap. Plus. Next one is nothing but 23j cap plus 0j cap plus 3k cap. Because there is no j here right now in this one. Isn't it? That will be equal to how much? Now see, add up all of them. This is your 3i and 23. How much I'm getting, you see? 23, I think. J cap, huh? This one. Okay, sorry. This is j cap. Sorry. This is 23 j cap means what I can write here is 0 i cap plus 23 j cap plus 3 k cap. Done? Okay. So it is 3, 4 plus 4, 7 i cap plus 2, this is minus j and 23. So 2 minus j is 1, 23 plus 1, 24 j cap. And minus, this is nothing right now here, 4. And that will be equal to your 3. So it is how much for me, beta? Minus of minus, minus 3, that one. That will become for me 0 k cap. Okay. So magnitude of this one will become how much for me? Mod of this one is under root of your 7 square plus 24 whole square. Just now we did 625. That will be equal to your 25 newtons. Okay. So acceleration is 25 divided by mass. So that will be equal to 5 meter per second. That's it. Okay. Check next one. A constant force is acting on a block of mass 5 kg, changes its speeds from 6 meter to 10 meter per second in traveling a distance 8 meter in a straight line. Number B, it speeds from 2 meter to 8 meter in 3 seconds in the straight line. Find the magnitude and the direction of your force. Can anyone do it, beta? What is constant here, beta? Constant force. Force is constant. F is your constant. That means acceleration is also constant. So if acceleration is also constant, I can use the relation v square minus u square is equals to 2s for the first part of equation. Speed is changing from, that means initial velocity is 6 meter per second and final velocity is 10 meter per second and it has been traveled a distance of your 8 meters. So v square minus u square is equals to us. I'm using right now here. That will be equal to 10 whole square. This will be equal to your 6 whole square is equals to, the next one is a plus 2 into a into displacement is 8. This is 6 is 36 plus 2a into your 8. 2a is 16. So it is 36 plus 16a. This one is nothing but of your 100. Okay. So this will be equal to how much, beta? Can anyone tell me? Anyone?
Sir, 4.
100 minus 36 is how much, beta? 64. 64 is equals to 16 times of your A. So A is equals to 64 divided by your 16. मच बेटा?
फोर
फोर सर
4 meters per second. So once I get an acceleration, I can calculate that constant force. F is equals to m into your a. Force is 5, acceleration is 4. So 5 fours are 20. 20 newtons is the answer. Is it clear? The constant force is acting on a block of mass 5 kg. Changes its speed from 6 meters to 10 meters in traveling a distance of 8 meters in a straight line. And number B, its speed from 2 meters to 8 meters in 3 seconds in a straight line. So I have done the first one. Can anyone try for the second one, beta? He has given me again initial velocity 2, final velocity as 8. But now instead of displacement, he has given me the time. So which kinematic equation I can use? Because your force is constant, acceleration is also constant. Can anyone tell me which equation I can use there, beta? Which equation? V is equals to u plus at. Final velocity is 8. Initial velocity is 2 plus acceleration a into your t. Isn't it? So 6 is equals to 3a. 3 ones are 3 twos are. So acceleration is equals to 2 meter per second square. Acceleration is 2 meter per second square means force will be equal to mass into acceleration. Mass is 5 into 2. That will be equal to 10 newton. Done? Next one. See this one. Two blocks are being attached by a light inextensible string and the system is being pulled by applying a force of F0 as shown in the diagram. Find the acceleration of the each block and the tension in the string. Can anyone do it, beta? One single string, beta, tension at each and every point will be the same. Here there is a tension T here. Here also same tension T. Here if there is a tension T, this one is also a tension T. So total body will move with one common acceleration, that is nothing but F equal to your A. Okay? So net force will be equal to how much, beta? Total body is moving with common acceleration. A is equals to your F naught divided by total mass. M plus 2M. That will be equal to your F naught divided by 2M. That is an acceleration, isn't it? So if I need to calculate the tension. So if I take a video of this block, beta, any block you can take, no problem. This is your T, second block. Moving with an acceleration A. So T will be equal to how much for me? M into your A. So that is your M into acceleration is F naught divided by 2M. M and M will get cancelled. So this will be equal to F naught divided by 2. So this will be equal to T. If you want to take other equation also, you'll get the same beta. Like say on the 2M, if I need to take, see on 2M, there is a force here of your F naught. There is a tension here, T. As the body is moving in the front direction with acceleration A, so it is F0 minus T is equals to 2M into your A. F0, how much we got, beta? Just now you see? F0 is equals to your. F0 is equals to your. I can write from this one. F0 is equals to 2M plus 3. This will be 3M, sorry. So this one will be 3M, 2M plus of your M into your acceleration A. That means this will become for me 3M into your A. This is your F0. So that F0 I can take there. 3M into your A minus T is equals to 2M into your A. So if I take this here, 3MA minus 2MA will be equal to T. That will be equal to M into your A is equals to T. Either you use like that or you do like this. It will be one and the same. Okay? Very good. Yeah. Clear, beta? Next one. Find the common acceleration and the tension in the each string. Can anyone try this question, beta? Make it fast. Two different strings here, beta. If I'm having two different strings right now like that, tension here will be equal to, like say, T1. Here the tension will be equal to your T2. Here the tension will be, sorry, here also will be the tension T1. And here the tension will be T2. And here the tension will be T2. Because in one single string, the tension at each and every point will be the same for me, isn't it? So whatever the tension you are taking, it will be equal and opposite will be acting. So here it will also will be T1. Clear for everyone? Okay? Sure. So first calculate the common acceleration. फोर्स अप्लाइड इज हाउ मच फॉर मी 40 न्यूटन. सो ए इज इक्वल्स टू 40 डिवाइडेड बाय दिस वन इज योर 5 + 3 + 2. So that is equals to 40 divided by 3 plus 2, 5, 5 plus 5, 10. So this will be equal to 4 meter per second square. So acceleration is 4 meter per second square. Now if I need to write the T1, okay, let me take the FBD of 2 kg block. This is a 2 kg block. Here the force is 40 Newton. Here the tension is nothing but T. The body is moving in the front direction with acceleration A. That means I can write here, acceleration A will be equal to, if the body is moving in the front direction, 40 minus T will be equal to 2 into your A. Okay, so this is your 40 minus 2 into your A is equals to T. So it is 40 minus 2 into acceleration is 4 is equals to T. So that means this will become for me 40. This is 40 minus, what is the 8, is equals to T. Okay, so it is your 40 minus of your 8. How much better? 32. So T is equals to 32 Newton. So this T, I took it as T1. So this will be your T1. Now can anyone tell me the T2 better? For T2. You can take 3 kg block or 5 kg block. See, if I take the 5 kg block, it will be more easy for me because there is only one force acting on that one. That will be equal to T2. And this body is moving with an acceleration A. So T2 will be equal to 5 into acceleration A. So it is 5 into 4. 5 fours are 20 newtons. Or else you can even take 3 kg block. Let's see if I take 3 kg block, how much I'll be getting. On the 3 kg block, the tensions acting are in this direction T1, in this direction T2. The body is moving in the front direction with acceleration. So how do you write the equation? Whatever direction the body is moving, that force 1, that is T1 minus T2 is equals to 3 into your A. So T1, how much I got? T1, I got 32 Newton. Okay. This one is a 32 minus a T2. Is equals to 3 into acceleration is how much? 4. 3 fours are 12. So it is 32 minus 12 is equals to T2. So how much I got here right now? T2, 20 Newton. So am I not getting the same thing here, beta? 2 minus 2, 0. 3 minus 1, 2. So T2 is equals to 20 Newton. Got it? What an idea?
Yes, sir.
Actually, I'm having full fever beta from Friday. I'm not feeling well. That is the reason some technical problems might have been happening. Even I'm fracturing like anything, basically. Anyhow, next question. The blocks are attached to by an inextensible light string and pulled vertically upwards by a force of 100 Newton as shown. Find the common acceleration and as well as of your tension. So diagram is been not given right now for this one. I need to check with the diagram. Just give me a time. Two blocks. Where is this question? Okay, this one. Yeah. The blocks are attached by an inextensible light string and has been pulled vertically upwards by a force of 100 Newton as shown. Find the common acceleration and tension in the string. Already so many times in the NEET such type of model questions have been asked, beta, so be a little bit of your calculator. Now can anyone tell me an FBD for this one, beta? See, weight of this body 3g is acting in the downward direction, tension in the string here T in the upward direction, tension in this string T in the upward direction. And weight of this body in the downward direction is also acting. That's the only thing you need to write here right now. Okay. That means if I'm writing the free body diagram for your 2 kg, what all forces are acting on the 2 kg block, you see? One force is 100 Newton in the upward direction. Another one is a tension T in the downward direction. And the weight of the body 2g in the downward direction. to G in the downward direction. That means as the body is moving in upward direction, 100 minus of your 2G minus of your T will be equal to 2 into some acceleration A. This will become for me 100 minus 2 into G value is 10 minus T is equals to 2A. So it is 100 minus 20 minus T is equals to 2A. 100 minus 20 is how much beta? 80. 80 minus T is equals to 2A. This is my equation number 1. Now for 3 kg block, now see the diagram. The body is moving in upward direction. So it is T minus 3G I can write here. Okay, I'm taking the next page. This is your 3 kg block. Tension T is in the upward direction. 3G is in the downward direction. As the body is moving up with acceleration A, so it is T minus 3G will be equal to 3 into your A. So it is 3 minus G into 10 is equals to 3 into your A. Is T minus 30 is equals to 3 into your A. This is my equation number 2. Okay. So now what I'm doing is adding 1 and 2. Adding 1 and 2. So what is the equation number 1? 100 minus that one. That means how much it is? 80. Together. So how much we got that one? 80 minus of your. ఎంత వచ్చింది అది 80 మైనస్ టి 80 మైనస్ టి ఇస్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు యువర్ హౌ మచ్ యూ గాట్ హియర్ 2 ద నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ టి మైనస్ ఆఫ్ యువర్ 30 ఇస్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు 3 దిస్ వన్ విల్ గెట్ క్యాన్సిల్ రైట్ నౌ దట్ 80 మైనస్ 30 దట్ విల్ బి ఈక్వల్ టు 50 దట్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు యువర్ 5a సో యాక్సిలరేషన్ విల్ బికమ్ హౌ మచ్ బెటర్ 50 బై యువర్ 5 is equals to area. So 5 ones are 5 tens. So acceleration is equals to 10 meter per second. Clear? Is it clear for everyone? Dheeraj?
Yes, sir.
Nandini, is this model clear for everyone? Can you try one model on this one? Karunya?
Yes, sir.
Try this question, but everyone. The blocks of masses 2 kg, 3 kg, and 5 kg are being connected by a light inextensible strings as shown. The system of the blocks is raised vertically upwards by applying a force of F0 is equals to 200 Newton. Find the common acceleration and tension in the strings. Chalo, try it. I'll give you a minute of your time. Please, everyone, try this question. But first, find out the common acceleration. I hope everyone can do the common acceleration very easily.
20, yes, sir.
Total system 20? Is moving in the upward direction.
Yes, sir. 200 by 10.
So acceleration will be equal to your F naught divided by total mass. F naught is how much for me? 200 divided by 5 plus 3 plus 2. That will be equal to 10. This one will get cancelled. So acceleration will be equal to your how much beta?
20 meters per second
square. Total mass. Ten kg no? Into g, that means into 10. What will be the net force beta? Total body has been moving in the upward direction. Net pulling force I can write here. That will be more better. We'll get an idea. नेट पुलिंग फोर्स डिवाइडेड बाय टोटल मास. वेट ऑफ दिस बॉडी 2g इज एक्टिंग इन द डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन. फॉर दिस वन 3g इज एक्टिंग इन द डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन. दिस वन 5g इज एक्टिंग इन द डाउनवर्ड डायरेक्शन. दिस आर ऑल फोर्सेस ना. सो मच इट इज. दिस वन इज योर 20. दिस वन इज योर 30. दिस वन इज योर 50. सो इट इज 100g. So this will be your 200 minus of your 100 divided by, okay, total mass of this body. Mass of the body is 2 plus 3 plus 5. Only masses I am taking, right? Okay. So it is your 100 divided by 10. This one and this one will get cancelled. So this one is 10 meter per second. Clear? Sir, why you are not using 200 minus 2g minus t? Not only I'm using, but first I'm doing the net acceleration. Net pulling force will be this total 2g in the downward direction, 3g in the downward direction, 5g in the downward direction. Isn't it? So if I like, if I take individually, if you're feeling not comfortable in this one, then go like this. This is on 2kg. On this one, there is a weight of 200 newton. There is a tension here in this one and also a weight of 2g in the downward direction. Clear? Let's say, for example, in this one, if I'm taking a tension of your T1, obviously here also it will become for me T1. Obviously here the tension will be T2 and in this one is also your T2. That means here is right now for me how much? T1. So if I write the equation, this will be 200 minus of your 2g. Minus of 2g minus of your t1 is equals to 2 in theory. That is a common acceleration. This is my equation number one. Then for 3kg block, for your 3kg block, down force is how much for me? T2. Up force is how much for me? T1. And weight of this body, 3g, is also acting in the downward direction. This will be your T1 minus of 3G minus of T2 is equals to 3 in theory. So it is a T1 minus of 30 minus of T2 is equals to 3. Okay. Even I can write like this. T1 minus T2 minus 30 is equals to 3. No problem. Equation number 2. The next one is last one. Last one is 5 kg block. On 5 kg block, the upper force is how much for me? T2. So T2 is equals to 5 into your acceleration. Weight of this body is acting in the downward direction here right now. This one is right now for me 5G. So the equation will be equal to your how much for me? As the body is being moving in the upward direction, T2 minus 5G is equals to your 5 into your E. So it is a T2 minus 5 into G value is 10 is equals to 5 into your E. So it is T2 minus 5 tens of 50. 50 is equals to 5 in theory. So T2 will be equal to your, how much for me? 5A plus of your 20. Like that I can write the relation and simplify it. I'll take this one as your equation number 3. Clear? So you can simplify the equation 1, 2, 3 and you can get an acceleration adding equation number 1, 2 and 3. Clear? What is the T1 beta you will be getting from this? T1 is how much? Can anyone tell me? So T1 will be equal to your 200 minus 2 into G is nothing but 20 minus T1 is equals to 2 into your E. 200 minus 20, that will be equal to 180. 180 minus T1 is equals to 2A. This is my equation number 1. Now add all the equations there, but you'll be getting the value of your acceleration. Isn't it? So I already got an acceleration. That value I'm substituting here. See how much I'll be getting T1. Therefore, 180 minus T1 is equals to 2, acceleration is how much? 10. So this will be equal to 20. So it is 180 minus 20 is equals to T1. So how much is T1, beta? 160 Newton. T1 is equals to 160 Newton. What acceleration already I got? 10 meter per second, like that. Or else you can take the equation 1, 2, or 3 and add them. You will get a common acceleration. Once you get a common acceleration, substitute in equation number 1. That will give me the value of T1. So T1 is equals to 160 Newton. So if T1 is 160 Newton, I can calculate the value of T2. Isn't it? So T1 is 160 minus T2 minus 30 is equals to 3 into. Acceleration of this one is how much, beta? 10. That is nothing but equal to 30. That means this is 160 minus 30 minus T2 is equals to 30. Can I write like this? So 160 minus of your 30 is how much, beta? 130. Minus again, this will come here right now. Okay. 130, this will come here right now. Minus 30 is equals to T2. So T2 will become how much? 130 minus 30 is 100. That will be equal to your T2. So T2 is equals to 100. Clear? So when T2 is equals to your 100, we just need to what right now here in this one? What was our condition to be required? Find the common acceleration and tension. Okay, common acceleration is 10 meter per second. T1 is equals to 160 Newton and T2 is equals to 100 Newton. Okay, or else you would have even got from this one also. T2 minus 50 is equals to 5 into 10. So this is a T2 is equals to 5 into 10 is 50 minus it will go here right now. That will be equal to your 100 Newton. In that acceleration, where did 100 come from, sir? Okay, see, this acceleration here I took here, see. Force, na beta. This is your 200 which you are applying in upward direction. But this 2 kg force, this 3 kg force and your 5 kg force are been acting in the downward direction. 2 into g is how much for me? 20. So this one is 20 Newton in the downward direction. This is your 20 Newton in the downward direction. This is your 30 Newton in the downward direction. This is 50 Newton in the downward direction. That means on this system right now, there is 200 Newton in the upward direction. And because of this weight, 100 Newton in the downward direction. The body is moving in the upward direction with an acceleration E. That is the reason I have written that pulling force on that body is 200 minus 100 divided by total mass. Got it, beta? Got it?
Sure. Excuse me, sir. Can't we do it directly as for the previous problem?
In the arrangement shown, find the acceleration of the each block, tension in the string and the reaction in the pulley. The string and the pulleys are light, that is massless. And M1 is greater than of your M2. Neglect the friction and the pulley force. I told you the common acceleration formula, beta. Can anyone remember the common acceleration? A is equals to your M1 minus of your M2 into your G divided by M1 plus M2. This is your common acceleration. And tension formula already also told you T is equals to 2 M1 M2 into G divided by M1 plus of your M2. So the string and the pulleys are massless. Neglect the friction. Find the acceleration. Find the tension. And the reaction in the pulley. Reaction in the pulley means here this will be equal to your 2T. This will be the reaction. Because the tension in this one will be equal to T. Here also it will be your T. And here also it will be your T. And here also it will be your T. Weight of this body is M1G in the downward direction. And this one also your M2G in the downward direction. Isn't it? So reaction force means R is equals to your 2T. That means that is a 2 into tension is already 2 times of M1, M2 into your G divided by M1 plus of your M2. So R will be equal to 2 into 2, 4 M1, M2 into G divided by M1 plus of your M2. Clear, beta? R is your reaction force. Done. So this is someone again good question, but 4 kg block to 3 kg block and 2 kg. Just write an FBD first for this one. So for this one, if I'm writing the FBD is better. The pulley is light and smooth. The strings are inextensible and the light. The system is released from the rest. Find the acceleration of each block, tension in the string and reaction in the pulley. Okay, same again. This one is your 4G. This one is your 4G in the downward direction. And here it is your 3G in the downward direction. And this is your 2G in the downward direction. Now tension in the string, if I'm taking right now here. So here there will be one tension, beta. This will be T1. And here also this will be one tension, T1. And here this will be equal to T2. And here also it will be T2. Here also it will be T2, and here also it will be your T2. As the more mass is here right now, so the body acceleration is in this direction, and the bodies of this acceleration is in the upward direction. Clear for everyone? Is it clear? So the basic way to calculate the acceleration, A is equals to net pulling force divided by total mass. Okay. What is the force here which is been acting beta? 4G, 3G. 4G means 40. 3G means 30. So total force here is how much? 70. 70 minus. This force is how much? 2 into G means 20. Minus 20. Divided by total mass. 4 plus 3 plus 2. 70 minus 20. 50. Divided by 4 plus 5. How much it is, beta? 9. Isn't it? 3 kg. This is your 4 kg. Sorry, this is not 4 kg, beta. This is given as 5 kg. The problem. Just correct it. This is your 5G. 5G means this will become for me 50. 50 means this will be 50, this will be your 80. 80 minus 20, that will be equal to your how much for me? 60. Divided by, this is how much? That? Is the acceleration clear, beta?
No, sir. The
net pulling force.
10, sir. Sir, acceleration should be 6 meter per second square.
Any doubt to anyone in this one? Yeah, this will be your 6 meter per second approximately. That? Sure. What will be the T1 beta? Can anyone tell me? T1 means on 5 kg block if I am writing like this. This is your 5G in the downward direction. And there is a tension of your T1 in the upward direction. The body is moving in the downward direction. That is the reason 5G minus T1 is equals to 5 into acceleration. So it is 5 into G is nothing but, sorry, this will be equal to your 50 minus of 5 into your 30 is equals to your T1. Isn't it? So 50 minus 30, 20. That is equals to T1. So T1 is equals to 20 Newton. Okay. Then T2, for 2 kg block, if I write FBD, for your 2 kg block, 2G in the downward direction, tension T2 in the upward direction. So T2 will be equal to your T2 minus of your 2G is equals to 2 in theory. So it is a T2 is equals to your 2A plus of your 2G. 2 into acceleration is 6 plus 2 into gravity is 10. 12 plus 20. How much it is? 32. Okay. So reaction force will be equal to how much beta? R is equals to C here. Reaction T2 and T2 means here the reaction force will be equal to 2 times of T2. So reaction force is 2 times of T2. That means 2 into 32 Newton. So 2 into 32 Newton is how much? 2 2 is a 4. 2 3 is a 6. 64 Newton. Clear? This model already I did in the problem. This will try to do it from the tomorrow session of your class. Okay. Please try to revise the Newton's laws of motion. Have you written the examination beta? How was the exam paper? Nandini? Arunya? Easy only. Okay, fine. Arunya? See, every weekend there will be an exam, but every 15 days one there will be an exam. Please try to prepare and don't try to go for an higher level of your questions. Try to be perfect with basic models. Even the papers, what we are keeping is purely keeping concentration of the NEET level. We are keeping the time also into constraint and trying to give the paper. It's not like just copying the questions from the material and giving you without any time constraint. Time constraints also we are taking into consideration. Hardly some difficult level questions are 4-5 and remaining all of them we are giving a moderate to easy type of a questions only. Dheeraj, have you written the exam?
Yes, sir. Raja, sir.
Raja or Dheeraj?
Yes, sir. Raja, sir.
In Raja?
Baran, sir. Baran. 5:30 yesterday.
5:30 or sir. Physics learners, right?
Physics 107 and Rajni, sir.
Karanya, Miko? Karanya, how many you are getting better? Karanya, Nandini? If you took the question, no, but I am not taken. Physics 103. Nandini, yourself? 54. Any key corrections are there? If you have any doubts, you can please post me. Okay. Take care, beta. Bye.